Hi everyone, in this video I will explain the real, true and deep reason, the deep why the INFJ and INTJ are not liked, ignored and rejected by the majority of the population and therefore by the society. I will do my best to explain in the most efficient way, correctly and in detail, so everyone can understand, at least the one who understands the 8 function model. If you have in mind these three concepts, the 8 function model, the reflection of ourself, and mature-immature, you will understand. We all embody our 8 function stack, our two first functions is what people see the most of us, especially the first, the dominant function, it's our aura, our main energy. Our mind and body are two sides of the same entity. What we show on the outside, what others perceive of us, is a reflection of the inside of ourselves, of our psyche, the reflection of our cognitive function. Cognitive function inside, behavior outside. Our behavior is a reflection of our own psyche. When a person is immature, unimproved, not developed, not individuated, their function stack, their eight function, are more visible, they are easier to determine because their lower functions are not developed, not learned, not integrated. They embody well the stereotype of their personality type. Their underdeveloped functions are more clearly shown and reflected in their behavior in the outside world. INFJ and INTJ have NI as dominant and first function. They embody NI, they represent NI, they are NI. I want you to imagine NI equal INTJ and INFJ. The majority of the population are the ISI user, the SJ type. They have SI as first function or second function. That means they also have NI as function 8, the demon, or as function 7, the blind spot, polar trickster. The ISFJ and ISTJ have SI as first function and dominant function, therefore they have NI as function 8 and demon function. When they are unhealthy, immature, unimproved, they don't care about their own NI, they don't want to deal with, they don't consider it, they don't accept it. By reflection of themselves, of their own psyche, they treat the INFJ and INTJ who embody NI the same way. They don't consider them, they don't accept them, they don't care of them, and may find them useless. When immature, INFJ, INTJ do the same, NI and SI are the demon function of each other, therefore INJ and ISJ are the demon of each other. The phenomenon is similar with the ISTJ and ISFJ. They have SI as second function, therefore they have NI as blind spot, polar, trickster function. It is the function they really don't understand, they find it useless, they don't want to see it, don't see the value in it, they are not interested by it. By reflection of themselves, of their own psyche, they treat the INFJ and INTJ the same way, they don't understand them, they find them useless, they don't want to see them, ignore them, don't pay attention to them, they are not interested by them, they don't value them, they don't consider them, the last person they think about, they are afraid of them. Especially the ISFJ towards the INTJ, because they are the perfect opposite. Their dominant function and blind spot function are switched. The same for ISTJ towards the INFJ. They are perfect opposite. Their dominant function and blind spot function are switched. Also, ISFJ and INTJ have a completely different function stack. And the same for ISTJ and INFJ. They both have completely different function stack. Whereas INTJ, ESTJ, if both engage with TE, they can get along, and INFJ, ESFJ can get along if both engage with FE. INTJ and ESTJ can get along better because both have in common TE and FI, and INFJ and ESFJ can both get along because they both have FE and TI in common. The phenomenon is also similar with the ESFP and ESTP. They have SE as dominant function, therefore NI as inferior function, that they may repress and prefer ignore, but it's also strange and paradoxal with them because it's both their fear, stress and aspiration. By reflection of themselves, of their own psyche, they treat the INFJ and INTJ the same way. They see them as inferior to them, they repress them, they ignore them, they are scared of them, stressed by them, and in the same time, they aspire to be like them and admire them. INFJ, INTJ, and IDOM, for the unhealthy ISFJ, ISTJ, we are the demon. For the ESFJ and ESTJ, we don't exist, they don't want to see us, we are weird, they don't understand us. For the ESTP and ESFP, we are inferior, repressed, but they also admire us and aspire to be like us. They mock at us, laugh at us, reject us, treat us badly, ignore us, don't consider us, don't value us, find us stupid. We really have the impression they don't want us to exist, they don't want us to be ourselves, and want us to be like the majority, like them. And the phenomenon is amplified when we are neurodivergent, gifted, Asperger, ADHD, or other neurological condition. They want and try to change us, they think something wrong with us. In reality, it's the reverse, nothing wrong with us, but something is really wrong with them. Anti-think is the awareness, the respect, the honesty, the love they don't have for themselves and others. Another reason is also because NI is the rarest function to have as first or second function. We are the minority, and like all the minority, they have tendency to be rejected by the majority, majority which is often considered as the norm. But for me, the word norm, normal, don't really exist, we are just all different. The immature, unhealthy, unimproved, not fully developed people don't respect, don't consider and reject their own function in themselves, they project it and also project their own insecurity into others who embody this function. They treat them badly, don't consider and don't respect them. They treat the other person, the other personality type, the same way as they treat their own function in themselves. They disrespect others the same way they disrespect their own function. If they don't accept another person, reject them, or treat them badly, that means they reject the same function in themselves. It's all about energy and reflection of ourselves. If someone don't like someone else, it's very possible they don't like themselves first and don't accept this function in themselves. And also they don't like this function in themselves. If you want a real life example, I am INTJ and IDOM. My mother is ESFJ and I blind spot. My father was ISTJ and I demon. And I have just the impression they treated me like their own NI function. They ignored me and wanted me to be more like them, more like others, more SIFE or SITE. When I was a child and adolescent, every time there was a school trip or when they had to pick me up somewhere after athletics training or competition or any situation, I was always the last person left waiting for her parents to pick her up, and I always felt stupid, ignored, abandoned, forgotten. I think my parents were very lucky that I was very patient and I never complained. In the same time, if I complained, parents yelled at me. It's both fun and sad, or people, parents and society, don't want us to express ourselves and our emotions. My parents said sometimes we forgot Elodie again, and now I realize that of course you forget me. I am like your own AI function that you don't respect, don't consider and prefer, ignore because it's your blind spot or demon function. I will give you some other examples. A TI DOM mock, loss or criticize the FI DOM or at other person who share their deep feeling. That means this person, the TI DOM, still didn't accept and integrate their own FI function. An INTJ will write to an INTP, you are not INTP but INTJ. That clearly shows the INTJ didn't accept and reject his own shadow unconscious function, any TIFESI. An ESTP is mad at or criticize an INTJ, whereas the INTJ did nothing bad, she was just quiet, she did nothing, she told nothing. It shows that the ESTP still didn't integrate and accepted her own NI function in herself. By applying the same concept, the 8 cognitive function, the reflection of ourself, and mature immature, I found the reason why the unhealthy people in the comment or in Discord MBTI community don't want INTJ to be INTJ. It's because they didn't integrate and accepted their own NI function in themselves. Another reason why NI is rejected by the society, simply because the society don't want people to improve. The society want people to stay stupid, they don't want them to improve, they don't want them to be themselves, they don't want them to be individuated, they don't want them to know themselves, they don't want them to integrate their unconscious and shadow side. They keep people unaware, low consciousness. They keep them in the negativity and fear to better control them with their emotion. So we to tell the truth. So the two problems why NI is rejected by society and why people don't want INTJ to be INTJ are solved. Next, what are the other problems? Tell me and I will solve them. It's so easy to solve problems that it gets really boring. You want the solution to make the world a better place, more harmonious and in peace. It's very simple, to raise the consciousness of people, and one of the tools to do it is to learn the MBTI, more exactly the 8 cognitive function model. I am sorry to say that if people only consider the 4 function model, they may still stay unimproved, not fully developed, not healthy and immature because they don't consider their own function 5, 6, 7 and 8. They don't want to confront their shadow, their unconscious side, that's all. I think it will be more difficult and will take more time to reach the individuation for people who only consider half of their function and prefer ignore the other half. Thank you so much for watching and see you in the next video.